Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you notice somebody has straight hair today, if you'd like to see my lengthy process of how I went from curly to straight, then stay tuned.
First product up, Kinky Curly, not today, and Kinky Curly Come Clean. The Come Clean is the shampoo, the not today is the conditioner. They are meant to be paired together. I love this brand. You're gonna see this on my channel over and over because once I find a product that works, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Okay, so you have to start off with clean hair. I tried different, at different points in my life, I've tried to straighten my hair and I noticed the results were different based on how I prepped it. So your hair does need to be clean and free of any buildup. So I want you to notice I'm only focusing on my scalp here. With natural hair, you don't want to strip the natural oils from the length of your hair. So I keep it in braids or twists while I am shampooing. And I just focus on the roots. So only the scalp and the roots are what I'm gonna focus on. Lather it up as many times as you need to before your fingers feel that your scalp is clean. So it's been a few weeks since I've washed my hair. I literally wait at least 2 weeks between my wash days. So in 2 weeks, you can kind of get a lot of buildup from just the sebum, that naturally occurs on your scalp. So here I'm just lathering up 2 to 3 times to make sure my scalp is absolutely clean. I would not recommend washing your hair if you are natural with your hair completely loose and piled up on the top of your head. I've done another video on this and maybe I'll link it below, but just make sure that you keep your hair in twists or braids while you're shampooing, and just if you are going to shampoo, use a sulfate-free shampoo. Next, blow drying. I'm using a Conair blow dryer. The blow dryer here doesn't matter, just long as you don't, burn your hair. So overnight I slept with a leave-in conditioner, the same conditioner that I just showed you on the screen. So I watered it down. If you look at my other videos, I have to water it down because I have low porosity hair and it will not penetrate my hair unless it's watered down. So keep your hair damp. Keep the shower cap on the parts of your hair that you're not working on and take it out section at a time. So you're going to blow dry the length of your hair while it's damp and while it has leave-in conditioner on it. I'm gonna take the nozzle, the concentrated nozzle tip, and aim it at the entire length of my hair. You can use a comb attachment if you prefer. Sometimes I prefer that. But I will say that this way creates the least amount of damage, okay? When you are using a comb attachment, you're running that comb through the length of your hair over and over and over, and that is just more manipulation to the hair strand. And if you want to maintain your length, you have to minimize damage. And this is one of the ways I minimize damage. I just skip the whole comb attachment to my blow dryer. I just use the concentrated nozzle. Your hair is already detangled because you washed it the day before. Well, for me, I washed it the day before because I can't wash and blow dry and flat iron in the same day. I don't have 20 hours to devote in one day. So the day before, I have already detangled it. So honestly, I don't need a comb attachment at this point. If you notice, I used a hair serum. I'm using Garnier Fructis Anti-Frizz Serum. This acts as your heat protectant, okay, and also slip. This is a silicone-based serum. Make sure that whatever heat protectant you're using is silicone-based or at least not water-based. Water is just going to undo all of the efforts of blow-drying your hair. So for me, it's like if I'm adding something extra wet to my hair when I'm trying to blow dry it, it's just counterproductive in my opinion. And plus I need the slip. So, silicone is extremely slippery and it will help keep my hair detangled while I am blow drying. So for some reason, natural hair just wants to like kink up on itself constantly. So as soon as you get one piece blow dried all of the way through, you're gonna notice that I'm going to twist my hair back up. So I'm gonna twist it while I'm working on the other sections. So right now I am finally getting this first section completely dry, and my hands are coated in the serum, and I'm just gonna twist it so that I can proceed to the next section. Clip it out of the way, take another damp section out of the shower cap, keep the others wet by keeping the shower cap on, and proceed. And I'm gonna show you one more time how I blow dry my hair, and then I'll speed it up for you so that I don't bore you with the lengthy 1 hour process of drying my waist length hair. So here I am, making sure she's detangled at every step. You can only do this while it's wet, which is why I recommend starting off with super damp hair. I have my blow dryer on the highest setting. This is a Conair 1875. I'm assuming that's the wattage. It just has a high and a low setting. It's nothing fancy. I've had it forever. I'm sure I found it at like a drugstore. So this is, I don't think the blow dryer itself is important here. Just make sure, you know, that there's never a point that you feel like you're burning your hair. Shout out to Mariah Carey, who likes her hair windblown. Anyway, time to flat iron. Okay, this is the moment we've all been waiting for. Yes, you saw that right. Don't you judge me. I'm pulling out the old school bergamot blue hair grease. You should have seen the nostalgia that I was feeling. Haven't used this since I was a kid. Anyway, I'm kind of excited. You can see the look on my face. This is a controversial product. I mean, I would never use this on my wash and goes, but when it comes to my press and curl hairstyles, something about that hair grease that just lay my hair down like she need to be laid down, okay? I'm using an Absolute Heat Pro Ion flat iron right here, and I've got it set to 410 degrees. And let me tell you, without hair grease, my hair will still get straight, but she will fly away instantly. And she won't have like the weight. I need it to be weighed down. So for me, it's like that heavy hair grease is what I need to keep my hair not only laying down and getting completely straight or as straight as I want it, but it also blocks out the moisture that's in the air. So if it was like a humid day, I could walk to my car and not have to worry about my hair reverting back to her afro state when I got this heavy bergamot grease, baby, okay? I'm trying to tell you, get you some heavy hair grease if your hair tends to fly away or frizz up quickly once you flat iron it. If you spend the number of hours that I spend on my hair pressing and curling it just to walk outside and it revert on you in 3 seconds, you will understand my appreciation for the hair grease. Now, I will say you're going to need a good shampoo to make sure you wash it out once you're ready to go back to your curls. But for the purpose of keeping my hair straight for several weeks, I need something heavy to coat these strands, okay? So you do not have to use it, but it has always worked for me. I've noticed a huge difference when I don't use hair grease. All right, guys, time for another link check. What? Is she swinging at the top of my, dare I say, buttocks? Yes.
How is they tell?
Oh my God, the anticipation of pressing this last piece. You just don't even know. Oh, guys, look. Look at it.
Look at it. We're all done. That took forever. I hope you enjoyed. I'll try to keep this for a good 3 to 4 weeks. That's the longest I've ever been able to pull it off. It starts to get dirty looking after that. But yeah, that's all I have for you. Enjoy. Till next time. Bye.